looking for it, but couldn't claim the spoils. Oshie comes in. Oh! He was charred by Phaneuf, and that is going to draw a crowd, and then some.
What a hit. Look at this. Shoulder down, stays on his feet, skates right through it. Whoa! Just think about how this would feel.
You know, you heard the whistle there. Sure. And sometimes guys just need a little bit longer to develop. Oh, Zadorov hammers Eichel as the Sabres were offside, and now everybody dogpiles to the boards on the near side. Holy cow. We've got to take a timeout. Jeff Skinner is all over to somebody. I think it's Rantanen. Everybody fired up.
I mean, Eichel, he's saying that the whistle had blown, and that's a good hard hit. But you can see what Zadorov brings. I mean, he is just such a physical presence because Eichel is a big, big guy.
Steps up to keep it alive. Great shift for the Ducks. And finally, it's sent all the way around, and as Cogliano brings it back in, and he's run over from behind by Jamie Benn, and that's going to get everybody's ire.
That's a cheap shot by
sure
Jamie
was.
Benn.
And Holzer gets to Benn. This is going to be interesting to see what comes of all of this. Cogliano on one knee.
He's kind of saying, you're going to go. Benn knows it's coming. I mean, when you deliver a hit like that, you know there's going to be a response. The whistle had already been blown.
Now to center, David Clement backing up the defense, dumps the puck in. Rask will set it up there. And the play is stopped, and then Adam McQuaid is hot at Kuhlman for the hit that he thinks is after the whistle. But what was the whistle for?
It was offside, and that's why he's hot. Because the rule is, on a delayed offside, as soon as you go towards a guy, they'll blow the whistle. And Kuhlman should have known. Everybody was yelling. And now Claude Julien's going, why am I not getting not only a penalty? That's why McQuaid's not expecting to get hit. The whistle's not only already gone, but he knew it was a delayed offside.
Trying to stick handle his way out of trouble, and he lost it because the stick got tied up, and a penalty coming up on the abs as a hit is laid there by McKechnie. And now Graves and Donskoy are in the mix, and everybody dogpiles into the far corner.
Yeah, right there is the penalty, and now the Avalanche are going to touch the puck. The puck goes in the corner, and there is the hit. Now, had the whistle not gone, that was going to be a fine hit, but the whistle had gone, so you relax, and then you get hammer slammed into the end boards.
They would have liked to have had Miller. Boy, there's a wipeout on a shove by Seidenberg at the horn.
Yeah, Shaw was going to look, make the big hit there, but the experience of Dennis Seidenberg, he saw Shaw coming. Smith put the body on him.
Sorry, interrupted you there. We're just listing all the goals here, and there have been plenty, haven't there?
Boards, here is Brown with it. Backhand, Brad Brown loose in front, and just failing to get a good wood on that shot was Kopitar. Rolls the ball. Oh! Extra move at the line. It's offside, and then Brown runs into him, and
Roosevelt hurt.
Yep, he is hurt. Ekman, Larson, and Dole both come over. And the question is, I don't see anything from the referees. This is an offside play.
The whistle goes a second before the hit happens. Roosevelt's got his head down.
Oh, wow.
And we already started singing, hey, hey, goodbye.
Turgeon scores! And he got dinked by Dale Hunter, and it's all open up now.
And this is after the Hunter giveaway. Turgeon, a nifty move, goes long side. He's celebrating. And Hunter says, not in my time. And he gives Turgeon a real good shot. He goes into the boards hard. And Turgeon is being tended to by the trainer right now.
They've taken the lead here on Turgeon's unassisted 5-1. That's the time remaining in the third.
Beating the Sharks, who continue to struggle at home. Offside is Anaheim here. Wow, and a big hit on Brandon Peary as the play is whistled down, and that's going to draw the ire of everyone in black as they try to get to the big rush in Trampkin.
Thank you, Jill. We'll get a couple of roughing minors out of this, Brian, as we take a look at how it all started.
Well, a little hit against Peary along the board.
Might have a shot at him. Fires a puck, it deflects off Voracek and in. And at center ice, Couturier just knocked Lehkonen down. And look at this.
Yeah.
Everybody's piling on here. 18 seconds left. The Canadians get some insurance into the empty net.
Let's have a look in the middle. How does this transpire?
He's turning and just ran into him.
And Lehkonen, he's fortunate, didn't get the cross check. That's the last thing he'd want to do. Does he hit him with this one? Boy, almost does. And then they both get after. And that's when Weber and Voracek.
Interesting to see what the referees call out of this.